You know, the last few weeks, or last 2 weeks, let me be specific, last 2 weeks, we've revisited or retraveled Resurrection Road. First, we went through the Old Testament. Let me say this, the Old Testament points to Jesus. It points Jesus at lots of people, places, and things that are similar to Jesus. Last week, we went down Holy Week Highway, Christ the King Boulevard, Crucifixion Way, and ended at Tomb Trail. Along the way, I hope, or I've tried to put you into the shoes of the disciples as they walk this road. Of course, it's a symbolic road. There is no road that I know of and called Resurrection Road. It's not in the Bible. But there is a road that leads to the resurrection of Jesus Christ. A symbolic road. And I've tried to put ourselves in that, in the shoes of the disciples as they walk that road. To the disciples, as we talked last week, to them, Resurrection Road seemed to end at the death of Jesus. Now, if I was in their place, I can see why they felt that way. Why it seemed to end there. They find themselves without a leader. They had followed for 3 years. They had watched him suffer a gruesome and horrific death at the hands of the Romans. We went into that in a little bit of detail last week. They were in a state of shock, disbelief, grief, not knowing what to do next. Think about it. Think about it. If you were in their position, I really want people to. The 12 apostles and those associated with them, put yourself in their place and what they saw last week. And it's Saturday night. They were shocked, disbelief, grief. I think at this point it's grief. The shock and disbelief have sort of worn off. The grief had set in. What do we do next? And again, they did not understand that they were traveling Resurrection Road. Again, Jesus didn't say we're traveling Resurrection Road. But a couple weeks ago, as they were heading on Resurrection Road, the disciples, and Jesus said, guys, he took the 12 aside. He said, this is what's going to happen. We're going to Jerusalem, and I'm going to be condemned to death. But 3 days later, I will rise again. And again, that part just, I think, right over their heads. They didn't understand the significance of Resurrection Road. And they did not understand that Jesus would rise up. Now say that again, they didn't understand that Jesus would rise up. See, we have the luxury of knowing that's the reason we celebrate Easter. That's the reason we celebrate that Resurrection Sunday. But they did not know that Jesus would rise up. You know, there are many signs along the Resurrection Road. They're saying that Jesus would rise up, but they missed it. Let's look at one of the accounts of the resurrection. In Matthew 28, verses 1 through 8. Now after the Sabbath, as it began to dawn toward the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary came to look at the grave. Put yourself in the place. Now look, this. I preached a sermon on this a couple years ago. It's called Ladies First. The women went to the grave. The men didn't even come. sat upon it. And his appearance was like lightning, his garments white as snow. The guards shook for fear of him and became like dead men. They just plain out of faint. And I saw this angel. And the angel answered and said to the women, "Do not be afraid, for I know that you are looking for Jesus who has been crucified. He's not here, for he has risen. He is not here. He has risen just as he said he would. Come and see the place where he was lying. Come and look at this empty tomb. Come and look at this slab where we got the ladies wanted, went there to put the body in there with them. See this place? He's not here." "And go quickly and tell his disciples that he is risen from the dead. And behold, he is going before you into Galilee. There you will see him. Behold, I have told you." And they departed quickly from the tomb with fear and great joy and ran to report this to the disciples. The story is well known. After the Christmas story, it is probably the next most well known. Jesus rises from the dead just as he said he would.
Amen.
Just like he said he would, he rises from the dead. The women are filled with joy. And they go tell the disciples. And we learn later, "Are you kidding me? Are you telling us the truth?" Yes. "Come with us and see where he was laid. He is not there." And them stubborn men run and say, "Sure enough, he's gone. He's risen from the dead." Have you ever wondered what happened in that tomb when Jesus came back to life? Don't you think about that for a second? I think we just sort of look at that. What might have happened? It's pure speculation. We all know sure he's dead and he's alive. So what might have happened? You can use your imagination. Blaine has always had a fairly vivid imagination. God might have said, "Son, rise up. Son, wake up. Rise up. Get up." To life as the Spirit of God and the Holy Spirit that we have within us, if you're a believer, he came back to life as the Spirit of God. Amen. Filled him up. And it's like a shot of adrenaline, I guess. You know, you see that where people, and they do this, the heart thing, they put a shot into them and like, boom. I mean, I don't know. A holy adrenaline, maybe. I don't know what you want to call it. I don't care. It don't matter. Or it might have been like God did to Adam and breathed the life back into him. I said, it really doesn't matter how it happened. It matters that it did happen.
Amen.
If died on the cross. See, the cross was just the beginning. If he had died and not risen from the dead, he's just another dead hero. Another dead religious figure that history is full of. The atonement is complete. The forgiveness of sins is complete. You no longer need to sacrifice animals. There's no longer a temporary forgiveness of sins. It lasted only for a year. There's no more blood of bulls and goats. Christianity is based on the fact that Jesus Christ did rise from the dead. He did rise up. And what the disciples do and his followers, their grief went to joy. Their grief went to this overwhelming joy. You know, it should do the same for us. It should do the same for us. We should rise up with joy at the resurrection of Jesus Christ. I'll say that again. We should rise up with joy at the resurrection of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Especially if you're going through a tough time right now. You know, we forget about the resurrection. The resurrection is everlasting. Jesus is alive forevermore. He is sitting in heaven at the Father's right hand, the Bible tells us. And hearing our prayers when the going gets tough. We should live every day as Resurrection Day. In reality, resurrection is just the beginning. It was just the beginning for the disciples. And it's just the beginning for us. It's just the beginning. You probably know the history of what happened from here on out. Every apostle of the 11, Judas committed suicide. We know about that. They picked another one. All of 11 of the 12 were martyred because of the resurrection of Jesus Christ. They never backed away from it. They believed in the resurrection of Christ. They went to their death believing and proclaiming. Are you going to die for something that's not real? No. Are you going to suffer hardship that someone did for something that you know that's not real? No. Peter. Christian tradition tells us that, Peter was about. I relate to Peter. Peter was hard-headed. Peter was boisterous. Oh, I know who you are, Jesus. You're the Messiah. You're the Son of God. Yeah, Peter. Oh, I will never deny you. Yeah, you will. Before the rooster crows, you'll deny me. No. I'll never do that. Peter, again, Christian tradition tells us that when he was martyred, when he was executed for his belief, we just going to crucify you, Peter. You preaching this crucifixion stuff and the resurrection stuff. We're just going to crucify you. Peter writes these words in his first epistle. Early on, we're going to look at 1 Peter chapter 1, verses 3 through 6. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. According to his great mercy, has called us to be born again to a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Has caused us to be born again to a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead. He goes on to say, to obtain an inheritance which is imperishable, undefiled, not fade away, and is reserved for you in heaven, who are protected by the power of God through faith for a salvation ready to be revealed in the last time. In this, greatly rejoice, even though now for a little while, if necessary, you have been distressed by various trials. You are born again to a living hope through the resurrection. A person cannot be born again if it's not for the resurrection of Jesus Christ. It cannot happen. Wasn't Jesus born again when he rose up from the dead? You will inherit eternal life. Be joyful in that. In this you should be joyful when times get tough. Instead of giving up, what do you think you should do? I think you should, I'm going to say what the Bible says, you should rise up. Instead of giving up, you should rise up. And let your sadness turn to joy. Now, I know that that's easier said than done. Now, you know, I've been around a while. I understand that. I'm just a preacher. I go through trials and tribulations like you. I've shared many of your trials and tribulations. And I know it's easier to say, don't give up, rise up. But I tell you what, if you'll tell yourself that over and over and over again, I'm not going to let this get me down. I'm going to rise up beyond this. I've seen people, I've seen your faces in the crowd. I see you. I know that you have not given up. You have risen up. We as a church should rise up and carry out the Great Commission. We as a church should have truckloads of stuff over there to donate to the Peace Place thrift store where they can make a profit that goes to restoring the life of abused and battered women. That is our mission. That will be our mission for next month. We need to rise up. We need to rise up and share the gospel with other people when we come across them in the public. We should rise up and pray for people. If you need it, rise up and be saved. I talked about that a little bit earlier. Don't run from God. Don't run from God. Rise up. Rise up and be saved. Rise up and be filled with the Holy Spirit. My goodness, you know, I wasn't raised a perfect person. I'm not a perfect person now, but my goodness, I got the Spirit of God within me. And all my faults and failures and sins and all that, and God overlooks it because of the blood of the Lamb. And sometimes I have to rise up from that. Filled with the Holy Spirit. Rise up from your troubles. Rise up and serve God. Rise up instead of having a pity party, rise up and serve God. You know what? If things get better, I've seen it happen, folks.
Amen.
kingdom of God.